Okay, good morning. We have already started the topic transcription. Several points already were discussed. That one important thing is that the when the gene gives the or when gene express, when it gives the information, it is information is the two terms. First, RNA synthesized, and subsequently then from that RNA a proteins are synthesized. But also keep in view that the all the DNA, cellular DNA is not expressed as the RNA at a time. Very few locations are there that are encoding the things. Within that also, whatever RNA which is synthesized, that is not exactly going to reciprocate into the protein. Only few or a smaller part is there. So that two points are very much important. Then we also discuss superficially that what is actually the transcription, how it is the initiation, initially important for the translation or protein synthesis, how the transcription in prokaryote and eukaryote is different. That also we discuss that as the nucleus is absent in case of prokaryotic system, everything is happens with respect to the cytoplasm. Then in our previous lecture, we also discussed regarding to the comparative study of DNA and RNA. Whatever RNA we have considered, that is the non-genetic RNA, means we are not dealing with the viral genetic sense. Whatever significance of RNA we have explained, that is the cytoplasmic or the metabolic biochemical significance. Genetically, RNA is not significant as far as the higher organisms are concerned. It's just responsible to transfer the information from DNA to RNA. mRNA, various features of mRNA, various features of the tRNA, various features of the rRNA. And beyond that also, there are several classes of non-translational RNA. Non-translated RNA means from that proteins are not synthesized. Besides the ribosomal and tRNA, we know that the small nuclear RNA, that is also as snRNA, microRNA, that is abbreviated as miRNA, short interfering RNA, guide RNA, regulatory RNA, antisense RNA, recognition RNA, and ribozymes. These are very important RNAs, and whenever time permits, whenever particular topic will become, at that time we are going to collect the more important information as far as these RNAs are concerned. Now we are going to start with this transcription, that is also referred as the gene transcription. So just like a replication, it is also divided into three steps. First is the initiation, second step is the elongation, and last step and third step is the termination. Okay. Now keep in mind that for a cell to operate, in order to become functioning, because once in form of DNA is now present as far as cell is concerned. But cell want to create a function, for example, glycolysis or the nitrogen fusion, whatever features are there, if the cell should be a physiological function, for that purpose, it needs a specific protein, specific enzymes. And for the synthesis of these proteins or the proteinaceous enzymes, RNA information should be important there, and henceforth, for the cell to become a functionally active, to operate, genes must be expressed. But cell is too much smart that whenever the particular gene is needed, at that time it is going to express. We are also going to explain this particular part when we study the lacoperon. In that we will see that when the lactose is present, then and then only the lactose gene are going to express. When the lactose is absent, the lactose genes are never expressed. But whatever, depending on the environmental situation, or many times so many things are without induction of environment also, this is referred as a gene expression. I already given the meaning of gene expression. Once again, I am saying that when the RNA molecule or subsequently protein, if the proteins are synthesized, still the RNA will be synthesized. Many times only the RNA will synthesize and nothing is synthesized from that RNA. That is also gene expression. And this synthesis is according to the DNA. The information is coded on the DNA. With respect to that, RNA transcript is formed, and then this particular protein is get formed. Next point is the DNA molecule that carries the original copy of genetic information used to store the genetic information. Because every time cell requires the information. Okay. So, example, once the RNAs are synthesized, in later on stages also the same RNA might be used, same proteins might be used. for that purpose always a source of information is the DNA, and so transcription is the only process from which the whatever information which is associated with that cell, that is the expression. The next is the physiological activities of cells are possible when working copies of genes are made from the RNA. Until and unless RNA not synthesized, the proteins are not synthesized, cell will not become a physiological active. Hence, for the making the physiological activity, this particular thing. I am purposefully mentioning this particular point because endospores, although these are considered as a live one, these are not considered as an inactivated one, but in endospore, transcription not takes place. Why? Because endospore is a not a physiological active. Henceforth, this particular point is very much important. Then the next is the transfer of information from DNA to RNA. It is referred as the transcription. It is also a clear point to you from first lecture we are going to discuss. This is a very important step as far as central dogma of molecular biology is concerned. And this process, the phenomena from which the RNA is synthesized, the synthesis of RNA according to DNA, okay, it is referred as the transcription. Here the word, both words are important. RNA is also important because it is synthesizing, and from how it is synthesizing, from the DNA is DNA. Synthesis of RNA with respect to DNA or as per the DNA information, this is referred as a transcription. It is a phenomena, and whatever resultant RNA molecule is formed, that is referred as the transcript. Okay, we can also label this particular newly synthesized RNA as a transcript. Now, prior to discussing first step initiation, we must be aware regarding to the several important things. Okay. For example, this is the DNA, that this particular DNA is undergoes the denaturation, means both the strands, the hydrogen bonds are broken, okay, inside that, and then RNA polymerase is very much important enzyme, just like a DNA polymerase is important for the replication. Here the important RNA polymerase, or you can say it is the central important, or you can say the hero of the process, without which the transcription will never take place. The RNA polymerization always proceed to the 5' to 3'. 5' to 3' means it is the on the 3' to 5' DNA. Means out of these two strands, one strand which is running from 3' to 5', on which these RNA transcript is get formed. Okay. And as for the sequence of RNA is complementary to the template strand. Okay. Why? Because say for example, wherever the A is there, according to A, the T will be there. I'm sorry, T is not there, U will be there. Means according to this particular DNA, the nucleotides are get added in this direction. And it is a complementary to template strand. The meaning of template I have already given to you, that the, you know, in Marathi we say that the sacha. Murti banavtana jasa sacha asto, the sacha jasa asel tashi murti bante. Similarly, actually tashi sacha tasa nasto, sacha ha complementary asto. Means jito tumhala unchavata paise tito kolgat bhaga. Okay, jito kolgat bhaga se tito unchavata mil. In that sense, it is a complementary. Henceforth, the sequence of RNA is a complementary to the template strand. And which is the template strand? The strand which is used to synthesize the RNA, just strand cha reference given RNA synthesis hoto hai, tala apan template strand. In previous case also we see that the with respect to template strand, the new DNA strands are synthesized. Here also, with respect to this template strand, the RNA is synthesized. Okay, you should keep, there is many times you might get confused, and so be clear with the terminology. The template strand is also referred as the non-coding strand. This strand is referred as the non-coding strand, and it is also referred as the antisense strand. Why this nomenclature is given antisense? Because this particular mRNA consists of the sense. Okay. And if you find the analyze this particular sequence, a totally opposite thing is there. This is the coded part, henceforth a non-coding, henceforth name that is given, means the alternative name for the template strand is a non-coding strand and antisense strand. While exactly opposite to the template strand, or whatever strand which is there, that is referred as the non-template strand, because it is not considered as a template for the RNA synthesis, it is non-template. This is also referred as the coding strand. Why? because there is the similarity between these RNA and this particular region. Hence, it is just like a coded region. Hence, it is referred as a coding strand, and it is also referred as a sense strand. Why? Because whatever mRNA sequence is there, quite same sequence is associated with it, which has a meaning. The mRNA sequence has a meaning. Hence, we are labeling it as a sense. Okay. Hence, so this is referred as the sense strand, non-template strand, or the coding strand. That's all regarding to the nomenclature associated with this particular phenomena. And also, you should keep in mind that the RNA synthesis is going to the 5' prime to 3' prime. Okay. Now we are going to start with the first important step in transcription, that is the initiation. In initiation of a replication, we are saying that the so many things are required: DNA A, DNA B, DNA C. Some sort of complicated things are there. Requirement of origin, all these things are. Here there is the involvement of two things are important in case of transcription. Initiation is mediated by the two component. One is the RNA polymerase, an enzyme, and another is the location which is present on the DNA. Because just like OEC, here also there should be some signal that from here you have to start the reading. From here you have to start the synthesis of RNA. And so particular specific location on the DNA and the RNA polymerase, these are the two important components as far as initiation is concerned. Already given that the RNA is synthesized by the enzyme RNA polymerase. These RNA polymerase, a core enzyme consists of the four subunits. Okay, two sub alpha, beta prime, and the catalytic site of this enzyme is formed by the beta and beta. And alpha subunit is required for the assembly and recognition of a promoter. Okay, these are the all peptides are the linked to each other. These are the quaternary structure. So many components are there. Okay, whether you are aware regarding to the example of holo enzyme, anybody have answer? What is means of holo enzyme? If you have, you can give me answer. Okay, this is also checking that whether you are listening or not. Means so. If you are listen my yes, who is going to explain?
Holoenzyme is enzyme required another factor for its activity.
For example, or you can elaborate your point. What are other factors?
Like in example of RNA polymerase, delta factor requires for its activity.
Okay. This particular RNA has the different important components are there. Okay. Here you will get a more clear these things. Two alpha subunits, 40 kilodalton, these two are there. And the function of alpha subunit is the assembled enzyme. Assembled means various peptides are there. These all peptides are aggregated. Second thing is the recognize the promoter. Promoter is actually the location on the DNA. I will explain this after the explanation of this RNA polymerase, that this particular promoter for the binding to that promoter, recognition is important. That recognition is also done by this alpha vector and binds to some activator. It not only support the enzyme structure, but also helpful to place to bound the activator. Then another is the beta subunit. It is the larger unit and 155 kilodalton. And beta prime, it is another subunit. It is 160 kilodalton. So this is the enzymatically promote the RNA synthesis. The RNA synthesis is actually the promoted by the this beta. But for the recognition, alpha subunit is required. Okay. And then a sigma subunit is also required. And that sigma is also have the important role in recognition of a promoter. Okay, so that is the thing. Here you can find this is the typical structure drawn here. Means two functions RNA polymerase has to play. One thing has to hold the DNA strand, whatever strand which is freely available from which the or which is the template strand, that holding should be done. And along with that, it also synthesizing RNA according to this particular thing. And for that purpose, a DNA groove is present. Groove means one sort of a hole. And here the RNA groove is present, means from this particular, just like flowers and threads are there, thread is internally. Similarly, the DNA is inserted here, and from that, that holding is takes place. And along with that, the simultaneous RNA synthesis also takes place. So that are the things associated with RNA polymerase has a deep groove through this middle that the accommodate the 16 base pairs of the DNA. That is also known that the in case of a bacteria, it holds only the 16 base pairs, while in case of a eukaryote, it holds the 25 base pairs. What I am saying that the this particular number, 16 base pairs are held in case of a bacteria, and in case of a eukaryote, a more number, means it gives also hint that the RNA polymerase of eukaryote has a larger structure. Then the next is that RNA polymerase of eukaryotic cell is larger. This I explained to you. Bacterial RNA polymerase consists of the two major factors, four enzyme made for the four subunits. I already given information, and along with that, it also has the sigma subunit. The core enzyme is responsible for the RNA synthesis, while the sigma units are largely responsible for the recognizing the promoter. Means at the initial stage, the sigma factor is needed. Later on stages, the role of sigma factor is not there. And henceforth, the enzyme without a sigma factor is referred as the core enzyme. Why? Because it intact structure is required for the synthesis of the this particular. That's all regarding to the structure of RNA polymerase. Now, a second important component, that is the promoter. Where the promoter is present, keep in mind, promoter is always present on the DNA. We are talking regard because the RNA is not yet synthesized. We are just talking on discussing on the with, and these are we actually everything is the nucleotide based pairs. Okay, but for our sake of convenience, we are giving the different names. So say for example, this is the region which labeled it as a gene. What is the definition of gene? Gene consists of the such a information which has the meaning from that RNA synthesized and protein synthesized, which has the active physiological role. Hence, it is referred as the gene. And actually, the task of this particular RNA polymerase is that to express this gene, express the gene means utilize this information and synthesize the RNA according to this gene. But for that purpose, it should be bound to particular region, and the region at which the RNA polymerase is bound, it is referred as the promoter. But now here also there are two important terms associated. The as per this particular direction towards the gene, this is the initial point of gene and this is the remaining part of gene. In this direction, whatever region from the first nucleotide or from the first amino acid in case of protein, this particular region on a gene is referred as the downstream region. Okay, and this particular region, which is actually not a component of a gene, it is the only the bounding site for the RNA polymerase. This consists of the upstream region. Upstream region, downstream region. Now here, this is the first nitrogenous base. It is denoted as the plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. In that way, depending on the gene's molecular weight or depending on that particular thing, this length might be vary. Already given that the mRNAs are not having the same thing. So genes are not a constant. Just like a spellings, they are the, or just like a sentence, they are the different sentence. But to denote this particular region, it this region, we are taking advantage means just beside this, this is referred as the minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus. What it indicates that the this nucleotide is away from 10 nucleotide with compare with respect to these things. So this is the minus 10 region, minus 35. Minus 10 and minus 35, these are the significance as far as promoter structure is concerned. Okay. Now keep in mind, only these portions should be synthesized, that could be the transcript. But for the synthesis of that, there should be the binding of RNA polymerase, and hence for the binding purpose, the specific region is there. That specific region is nothing but the promoter. Okay, and you should consider in your mind that the region which maximally gene occupies, it is referred as the downstream region, while the 5 prime end region, this particular region, this direction, it is referred as the upstream region. So this is the downstream, this is the upstream region, and promoter is located in an upstream region. Now here this is the same part is magnified, and at the minus 10 there is a particular sequence TATAAT, and at minus 35 also there is a particular sequence, and that is recognized by the sigma factor. This particular inverted U-shaped structure is nothing but the RNA polymerase. And I have given the hint that the sigma factors are required to recognize the promoter. Henceforth, these sigma factors are recognizing this particular sequence here and here, and henceforth the enzyme able to bound it. In absence of sigma factor, the enzyme will never bound it. For the synthesis, a core enzyme is required, but for the recognition of this particular things, promoter region, this is mediated by the sigma factor. One by one, we are going to collect the information regarding to this particular phenomena. The first thing is that the sigma subunit of RNA polymerase recognizes two special sequence as shown in the diagram, coding region of the strand. Okay. Now, these sequences are present in the non-template strand. Okay. Because still now, the DNA is a double-stranded. And whatever sequence at the minus 10 and minus 35 we are discussing, these are present at the non-template region, means which is not going to utilize for this particular synthesis. Then these minus 10 sequence and minus 35 sequence, why such name is given? I already given that they are backward in reverse direction at approximately 10 and 35 base pair with respect to the first base of mRNA, gene's first base. And in the reverse position, this is there. The minus 10 sequence is known as the Prebnow box. Now, whatever material, whatever things we are discussing here, which is with respect to the bacterial transcription. In case of eukaryotic, some sort of another differences are there. I will also explain that when we are learning a gene regulation of a eukaryotic. But here, for understanding purpose, you should keep in mind this is the particularly important for the bacterial system. They had minus 10 sequence Prebnow box. This particular box is this particular sequence is reported as a Prebnow box. And why the name is there? It is to honor the discoverer Prebnow. Okay. While at a minus 35, this particular sequence is reported as the Tata box. Means the region, the sequence which is associated at the minus 10 region, it is a Prebnow box. And the sequence which is associated with minus 35, it is reproduced the Tata box. Okay, many T are there. Actually, here also you will find TT, but it is already given the name as a Prebnow, hence it is reproduced as the Tata box. The Tata box and Prebnow box are actual the site where the sigma factor can capable to bound, and then it recognizes. Okay, these are also reproduced the consensus sequence. Consensus means their sequence is a constant with respect to so many promoter regions are concerned, or the so many bacterial regions. Actually, we can't expect that the every and each bacterial DNA, every and each bacterial, for example, E. coli in the E. coli promoter or in Salmonella promoter, the sequence will be same. No, not. Why? Because the totally different kind of genetic constitutions are there. But promoters are generally shared, means very rarely one or two nitrogenous base are getting different. Many times, this sequence is reproduced as a consensus, means it has a capability to show the same sequence in case of a, it will not get vary with respect to the space. That is the meaning of a consensus. Now, it is also clear to you that the sigma factors are required initially while the core enzymes are later on required. Henceforth, now it is possible to you to understand the sigma subunit of RNA polymerase bind to the promoter. First step, it opens the double helix locally to form the transcription double. Now, here also there is no need to denature the DNA. In the former case, in case of DNA replication, role of DNA A, DNA B, AT, rich region, so many things are there. But here, individual RNA polymerase itself sufficient in order to open the two strands. Means first it got bound to the non-template region by recognizing the Tata box and Prebnow box, and now the second task is that it is opening, denaturing these two strands. Henceforth, the template strand should be made available for the DNA polymerase, whatever shown in the diagram, in order to hold into the major room. After DNA helix has been opened, the single strand of RNA is a generated using one of the DNA strand, because both the strands will never use, and so only single strand will be done, that is already given the name, that is the template strand. Once the RNA polymerase has bound to the DNA and initiated a new strand RNA, once it is bound, then a role of sigma factor is vanished, and hence for the sigma subunit is no longer to needed and often detaches from the DNA. What is the significance of sigma factor? That you just direct that start from here, bound here and then start. Once the process is going on and this particular denature structure is replied as the transcription bubble. Why is transcription bubble? Because typical bulging is takes place and within that the RNA is going to synthesize. Two strands are get away from each other in order to make a template strand freely available. Hence, this is referred as the transcription bubble. So this is the typical transcription bubble, you can say. This is the template strand. RNA polymerase bound to this particular region, and once it has initiated the same thing, then the role of sigma factor is there, and in that way it is going to proceed. Now, this is the initiation, then remaining thing is the elongation. You already know that in elongation, same thing happens repetitively. So with respect to this thing, when the C is there, G will be there. Whenever the T is there, A will be there. Whenever the A is there, U will be there. One thing keep in mind here, it is the RNA, hence for thymine is not there. Here the uracil will be there. Okay. Now, what happens as far as the remaining consequences of initiations are concerned? The RNA polymerase remains with the promoter until the new strand 8 to 9 base long. Means here, as shown here, the 8 to 9 base pair long. Then the sigma factor, at this point the sigma leaves, not immediately. Because once it is bound, then along with that it synthesizes to 8 to 9 bases, and after synthesis of 8 to 9 base, everything is okay, then sigma factors are get dissociated from these things. Okay. Now the first transcribed base in the mRNA is normally an A. The first transcribed base is always a A. Means plus 1 is always a T in case of a G. Henceforth it is a A. This special A is usually flanked by the 2 pyrimidine. Okay, that is also defined many times. Okay, henceforth the initial sequence is the CAT. Okay, I'm talking with respect to the DNA. This CAT, very rarely first transcribed base is the G, but it is never a pyrimidine. Means either it is a A or it is a G. But many times it is a A. The first transcribed mRNA's first nitrogenous base which is synthesized is the A, or a very rarely G, but it is never a pyrimidine. Okay, others are not there. The next is the synthesis of mRNA is from the 5 prime to 3 prime. Already I have given the direction 5 prime to 3 because it is on the template strand 3 prime to 5 prime. Okay. Now and proceed at about the 40 nucleotides per second. Then compare, in case of DNA it is more than 1000, okay, base pairs per sequence, but here it is not have a much more speed, it is a 40 nucleotides per second, and hence it is a slower process. Transcription is a slower process as compared to the replication. Okay, and henceforth even the you should know the rate of a polypeptide synthesis that we are going to discuss in the next chapter, that is the translation. But the 15 amino acids per seconds are added. Okay, and here this particular is added by the 40 nucleotides per second. Then what happens whenever these denaturing takes place? At that time you already keep in mind that the DNA is a superhelix, and whenever the RNA polymerase is going to forward further and further, it responsible to induce the change the supercoiling. The negative supercoiling of the chromosome promotes the opening of the DNA during the transcription process. And RNA polymerase moves along with the DNA, it winds the DNA tightly ahead of itself and creative positive supercoiling. Okay, as it DNA polymerase go further, this former part of this particular DNA undergoes a positive supercoiling. Henceforth, equivalent negative supercoiling should be there. Then and then that particular stress will be removed. Already you know that the swivel mechanism is very much important. Otherwise, DNA might get broken. Henceforth, here also precaution is taken, just like in replication. The unwound DNA behind and which generate the negative supercoils, and for the restoring the supercoils, a DNA gyrase take care DNA gyrase, which is keeping with the distance to the RNA polymerase, and then it introduced the negative supercoiling. And for that purpose, once again the complications are there. Henceforth, systematic cutting, which will remove the supercoiling, negative supercoiling, that is also needed, is along with the help, because DNA gyrase, for the DNA gyrase, for the helping, topoisomerase is required. You already know that the topoisomerase 1 have capability to introduce the nick to the single strand. Out of two strands, one strand is going to nick by the topoisomerase, means by means of the DNA gyrase and topoisomerase 1 same enzyme, which is working in the replication system, the supercoiling is there, and in that way now the elongation process starts. So this is the typical elongation process. Means same thing is happening now. Now from here the DNA gyrase is going further, topoisomerase is going further, and depending on that the RNA, depending on the template strand, RNAs are synthesized. This, that's all regarding the elongation. Then what happens in the termination? A special sequence is present, because just in order to initiate the transcription, promoter is required. Similarly, there is also sequence present on the gene that is reported as the terminator. The terminator is the sequence which is present on the DNA, which also gives the information that here the transcription should be stopped. It should not continue up to the end of the DNA. And so the terminator is the template strand. Terminator is present on the template strand of the DNA, and it consists of the two inverted repeats separated by nearly six bases. Here it is shown. Okay. Actually, the terminator might be different in case of a different organism, but this is just example given. Generally, it is consists of the six nucleotides. Here you will find the this particular region, and this particular region is an inverted repeat. Okay. The six nitrogenous bases here, if you see this particular thing, that these are the inverted repeat. Means same thing is that there, you will find that the TGCCA, similarly that same repeat. Okay. Then that is followed by the poly A. Then that followed by the poly A. This AAA. Okay. Now, thus poly A in the DNA subunit gives rise to poly U. Because if the A is there, here the U will be synthesized at the 3' end. Hence, you will many times will find the so many U's after the synthesis of mRNA. Once the mRNA is get detached, and if you analyze the 3' end of the mRNA, you will find many U. The reason is that why? Because so many A's are there. Now, what happens when these inverted repeats are synthesized? When this particular inverted repeats are synthesized here, okay? What happens due to the complementary structure, the loop is get formed. Here this structure and this structure both are inverted, and so they are complementary to each other, and so loop is get formed. Okay, and this particular loop, just like here, this particular loop is get formed, and this loop is referred as a hairpin like structure. Means remaining DNA RNA is the linear one, but here the, as the inverted repeat are present in the DNA, accordingly this particular thing, and hence immediately the loop is get formed. This hairpin structure interferes with the functioning of a RNA polymerase, and it gives the direction hints that up to this point you have to synthesize, then you have to leave. Okay, henceforth several U are get attached, and due to the hairpin the RNA polymerase get problem. Because within that DNA group, this particular hairpin can't hold, and so it is totally hard its speed, and then it get detached. This particular process, and henceforth everything is get detached, and once again this DNA becomes the double stranded because it is a locally denatured only. Now what happens with respect to termination? There are several things are important. Longer RNA molecule contain many possible hairpins. That is also important thing is that, because otherwise the DNA polymerase can't stop. Once the DNA and RNA have the separated the terminated structure, the RNA polymerase leaves and find another gene. It completed. Now this particular RNA polymerase can once again go into bound to the promoter, same promoter, or it may also recognizing the another promoter. Now here, just mere formation of hairpin is not necessary. Along with that, So there is also several factors are required, not required always, but in several cases these are required. In several cases the hairpin structure is sufficient to stop this thing. The two classes of the terminators are there. One is the rho dependent terminators, which require the rho protein. Means just mere hairpin formation is not sufficient, along with another protein that is referred as the rho protein is required. In presence of rho only the RNA polymerase get detached. In several cases, it doesn't require the rho, and this is referred as the intrinsic terminator. Means terminator itself forms a such a hairpin loop that totally disturb the assembly, and automatically it becomes even in absence of rho dependent terminator, rho proteins, the terminator behaves like a terminator. So rho dependent terminator are commonly present in the bacteriophages. Rho proteins are isolated from the bacteriophages since its significance is in case of a bacteriophages. While a rho protein is a specialized helicase, actually the physiological role is just like a helicase, which utilizes ATP in order to unwind the DNA RNA hybrid, because DNA RNA also forms the hybrid structure. And just like a helicase, the DNA dependent rho dependent factor, so rho, which is a common in case of bacteriophage, which plays important role, and then it separates this particular assembly. What is a rho? The information is also available regarding it. The hexamer means made up of a 6 identical subunit, which recognize the 50 to 90 base pairs located on upstream of the terminator. Here also it have the affinity for the terminator region, but terminator of the mRNA. Means 50 to 90 base pairs which is part of the terminator that are get recognized, and it got bound. Once it got bound, then it responsible to separate by means of a helicase activity, and henceforth the RNA transcript is separated, DNA intact molecule separated, and RNA polymerase separated in form of a terminator loop. Later on, this terminator loop may get a linear by, or it may be processed by means of several modifying processes that we are going to discuss the things. But here, that is the sufficient information regarding to the initiation, elongation, and the termination of transcription. So that's all. That is the information for today. In next lecture, in tomorrow's lecture, we are going to discuss that what happens once the RNA is synthesized, then what happens to it. That we are going to discuss in the tomorrow's lecture. That's all regarding to the transcription process. We have discussed this process with respect to the bacterial physiology. Some sort of the same methodology is same phenomena, same steps are there in case of eukaryotic system also, but slight differences are there with respect to sequence and all these things are concerned. But whenever time permits, at that time we are also going to collect the information regarding the eukaryotic transcription, particularly when we are going to discuss the gene regulation part. But this is the all important basic aspect regarding to this. Also, there are several models are also proposed, like for the how the elongation takes place, what are the orientation of RNA, what is the orientation of DNA polymerase, and all these things. Once this particular part is grasped by you, then I will also going to explain what are the other theories are associated with. But in next lecture, we are going to discuss regarding to the further processing of RNA, whether whatever RNA which is synthesized by this process is directly available to translation, or whether there are several processing that takes place. That is the point of discussion as far as our next lecture is concerned. That's all regarding to the today's lecture. If you have any question, ask me. Also, I request you to please also write down your question in your notebook. Henceforth, if the time is not permitted by this particular software, henceforth we can continue in future also. Clear this, Durvesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then we are going to stop now.